60 more unclaimed cadavers of new Bilibid prison inmates have been buried by the Corrections Bureau. Some of those bodies were stored at a funeral parlor in Muntinlupa City for nearly a year. Bucor in charge Gregorio Katapang Jr. blames the Bureau's messy system for why the inmates' relatives were not informed about their deaths. Earlier this month, over 100 cadavers in various states of decomposition were discovered at the Eastern Funeral Service. There is an ongoing autopsy on some of the bodies that have not yet been claimed. Meanwhile, 234 inmates are released from various prisons across the Philippines. Over 100 were freed from the state penitentiary in Muntinlupa City. More than 100 persons deprived of liberty were granted parole. The others have fully served their sentences. Justice Secretary Remulla says more inmates will be released.
Ito ay pang-apat na pagkakataon ako ay nagpunta rito upang magpalaya ng ating mga PDL. Sinabi ko sa United Nations na pagdating ho ng June, mahigit 5,000 na ang ating pangkakawalan sa mga PDL natin sa buong Pilipinas.
Skeletal remains found at an excavation site at the Department of Justice compound in Manila. The excavation is for the construction of a new building. Among those recovered, a skull which appears to have a hole. Justice Secretary Remulla says this is not the first time skulls and skeletons were recovered inside a DOJ compound, which is rich in history. The NBI has been tapped to investigate the discovered remains. Archaeologists or personnel from the National Museum may also be tapped.
History talaga rito. When that was dug up, pero dinahanap na. Manila is a very old city. We don't know. It can be part of the war. We don't know.
Sa ilan po ako?
Remember, during the war, wasak lahat to. When the war happened, open city ang Manila. Marami talaga nangyari dito. So we really don't know. If it's a very old remains or how old they are. But there's a history, of course.
Remulla adds the construction of the building will continue as it is already delayed. In other news, a development studies professor stresses the importance of land reform in reducing poverty in the Philippines. Professor Leland de la Cruz of the Ateneo de Manila University believes this should have been highlighted in the World Bank's latest report on rising inequality in the country.
If I have a criticism of the World Bank report, mm-hmm. I'll be one of them. It talks a lot about inequality, but it does not talk about asset redistribution. Mm-hmm. So our land holdings historically have been very unequal, and to a large extent, land is the basis for wealth in many parts of the country.
That report showed a significant decline in the poverty rate here in the Philippines over the last 3 decades. But it also showed the gap between the rich and the poor has only gotten wider. Salaries here in the Philippines are set to increase next year for both public and private sector employees. But are the wage hikes enough to help bring down poverty and inequality? More from Warren de Guzman.
Rizal de Duterte is a nursing aide at a public hospital providing for his wife and 3 kids. He will be included in the final tranche of salary increases under the Salary Standardization Law of 2019. But he doesn't expect the hike to make a difference.
Depende po yan sa ano ng Kongreso. Deliberate pa sila sa Senado. And then, kung anong mapapagkasuduan nila, yun ang ano sa amin. Hindi na namin na nararamdaman kung pumasok na ba yung increase o ano.
Meanwhile, a survey by Mercer covering nearly 450 respondent organizations across 11 industries in the Philippines show salaries will be rising by 5.5% in 2023, a rate last seen in 2019 before the pandemic. The survey also shows that the increase is higher than the Asia-Pacific average of 4.8%. Party List Representative Franz Castro says these developments are encouraging, but they don't change the fact that wages are still far from where they should be. The lowest salary level of Grade 1 Step 1 of government, for example, will only pay 13,000 a month after next year's increase.
Ang panawagan namin ay at least 33,000 para sa mga government employees, no, doon sa salary grade 1. Ito naman ay nakabatay rin doon sa family living wage na at least 1,100 per day ang dapat na sweldo. So napapanahon ito para makaagapay yung ating mga workers and employees doon sa ating inflation and rising cost of services and other expenses.
In October, Philippine headline inflation hit 7.7%, the highest level in nearly 14 years, and higher than the average salary increase seen in the Mercer survey. The year-to-date average for headline inflation as of October is 5.4%. Meanwhile, the Employers Confederation of the Philippines notes the survey does not capture the entire economy, as the micro, small, and medium enterprises that make up the bulk of the economy don't often take part in these kinds of surveys.
Pag nagtaas ka ng minimum wage, pag tayo sa sweldo, nataas pa yung kita ng tricycle driver, alalaman siyang kumpanya, yung farmers, nataas pa yung sweldo niya. So ang dapat approach niya talaga ay yung totality. Sama mo lang, it is deceiving to say na magtataas ka ng sweldo, kaya pa ng kumpanya. Yung mga kumpanya, yung malalaki, eh, hindi naman sila lawyer ng 90%.
Socio-Economic Planning Secretary Arsenio Balisacan, for his part, says the government will accelerate poverty reduction programs to reduce pay inequality. This includes efforts to offer equal opportunities in education, healthcare, and nutrition to the poor, and these will be featured in the Philippine Development Plan 2023-2028, due out this December. The government fully believes that education in particular, including upskilling and reskilling the poor, will go a long way in helping them find better paying opportunities. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.